used to work for a megacorp.
And you are sure we will have those defense batteries up and running?
No. I'm not sure. They're in bad shape, Del. Really bad shape. I'm already using duct tape and spit to keep the station from falling apart. You want me to pull a rabbit out of my hat?
I don't want to hear excuses. I want to hear that it's going to be fixed. Period. Get it done.
All right. I'm on it.
You want to quit standing there and hand over the conduction grid data?
Perfect. I'll take that.
Dependable as always. Unlike some people we know.
Oh, that's real funny.
All right, listen up, because I don't want to repeat this twice. We've gotten word that UC SysDef is massing somewhere nearby for an attack on the Key. While we prepare for their arrival, I want you to head straight for Bannack 4 and bring Crixus Legacy home. Just slow down and listen before you jump the gun and ruin everything. Lay it out, Jess.
All right, first things first. I'm gonna upload this data you snagged from Genardyne into the Key's databanks. All you need to do is build and then install a conduction grid module onto your ship. Oh, and if you haven't already, you'll need the comm spike module installed as well.
Oh, is that all? And here I thought this was going to be a challenge.
Once your ship is ready, jump out to Bannack 4, board the Legacy, and bring us the cash. Of course there's a catch. What, you thought this would be easy?
After you board the Legacy, be on the lookout for two transfer modules. They're special keys that allow access to the ship's vault. Once you locate the vault's control center, hook up the data core I'm gonna give you, and download everything they've got.
And before you get any bright ideas, like running off with the money, that currency is going to be heavily encrypted. Only a genius like Shinya will be able to crack that encryption, so bring it back here right away. Yeah? I sure hope so. Look, I'm gonna make this real simple for you. If that money ends up anywhere but the Key, I will hunt you down and pry it out of your dead hands myself. Now get moving. Get moving before it's too late.
I need to get those defensive batteries online, so make this fast. Not a problem. Conduction grid data is all set up in the system, so should be an easy install. I bet you would. I'm just kidding. Let's take a look.
I find the interior.
Sometimes we'll take the long-range fighters out for grav jump and patrol
high. I don't know about you. No, I don't. But I do know the previous occupants of that interrogation chair you were sitting in. Not good people, to say the least. I think one of them even strangled a man with his teeth. But if Commander Ikande says you're Sysdef, then you are one of us. For now. You guessed it. In fact, I'd say you've got what linguistic experts call FOGO. A firm grasp of the obvious. But I'm not just any pilot. I'm the best. And I've got the kills to prove it. On that, we agree. I guess we'll have to test that theory out someday, Hotshot. Long story. I got my start in the Academy and made a name for myself hunting the Crimson Fleet. I eventually got recruited to do test flights on a star station orbiting Loyden's Rock. Me and three other Archangel pilots did some work on some extremely dangerous prototypes, but I called in a few favors and got back home with Sysdef. Someone with my talents needs to be here, where the action is. Yeah, it was. And you can probably guess what project it was for. I cut my teeth on space trucks, believe it or not. Before I got my stripes, I was just another cargo hauler trying to earn an honest wage. But after a couple slick escapes, I got recruited to the Academy and went from dodging pirates to hunting them. Thing is, some of my best tricks were with a big rig. Ever try a pitchback with a Hope Tech truck with two fleet wraiths on your tail? Compared to that, doing it with a military fighter is a piece of cake. Yeah, I thought you might. I heard the fleet sent you up there for some more pirate work. Even more impressive, you managed to do it without taking any lives. Maybe I misjudged you. That's more than I can say for myself, given the history of Project Archangel. The official word is I was transferred back to Sysdef because the need was great. The reality is I was kicked off the unit. I was so bored on that station, I spent all my time in the barracks drinking cases of smuggled booze. When the time came for my test flight, I was so wasted, one of the others had to cover for me. The engine caught fire right after takeoff. Pilot, crew, gone in a flash. No, they were just doing their job. The only one who wasn't pulling their weight was me. People tell me all the time it's not my fault. But fault's got nothing to do with it. I should be a dead man. Instead, some other pilot took my place.
I woke up in the middle of the night once and found peace.
Lieutenant Toft is as organized as they come.
All support ships have arrived, Commander.
Good. After we're done here, arrange it.
Time with those pirates.
I want one of your COs over here as soon as possible.
Hold out a little longer.
Yes, sir.
Back to the good guys soon enough.
Those pirates are going to look like fools when we take the legacy from under their noses.
There you are. Where have you been? I've received the reports about that stunt you pulled inside of Genadyne. Opening fire inside a civilian facility. Are you out of your mind?
Genadyne is furious at us right now. They want Commander Ricande to resign.
You always have a choice. People have died because you were too stubborn to find a safer solution. This is not how you see SysDev operates. I don't care if we're one step away from Crix's legacy. If you do it again, you're off this operation, and I'll have Toph throw you in the brig.
It'll be my pleasure, sir.
All right. I think we're all in agreement here. So let's get back to the operation at hand. It's time to put all the cards on the table and prepare to attack the key. Good. The more confusion and panic we cause, the more damage we can potentially inflict. Before you jump to Bannock 4, I need to make one thing abundantly clear. The credits from that Galbank transport cannot reach the fleet. You have to bring them here at all costs. If Delgado gains access to those resources, we might be touching off a battle we can't possibly win.
We've been monitoring the Crimson Fleet's comm chatter in the Crix system. They're gathering allies by making promises based on your success.
As much as I hate to admit it, UC SysDev won't stand a chance. The fleet will become stronger and more unified than ever.
You cannot help but admire their commitment to their mission.
The only admiration I hold for the Crimson Fleet is the fact that they aren't going to be a problem for much longer. I've always known that when it came down to it, you'd do the right thing. All right, I guess this is it. Do whatever prep you need to do aboard the Vigilance, and then head out to Bannock 4. When you return here with Crix's legacy, we'll begin the attack. Good luck. The evidence you've been bringing to Lieutenant Toft has been instrumental in convincing the brass at MAST to greenlight the attack. They've sent us support ships, extra troops, weapons, all on account of your role in the operation. Put it simply, if it wasn't for you, this operation would be at a standstill. During the end of the Nerion War, the money was destined to bolster the Freestar Collective's coffers. Even though we were rivals at the time, and I suppose we still are to some extent, the credits still rightfully belong to their people. After the money is turned over to MAST, I'm certain arrangements will be made to return the money to the proper authorities in Aquila City. All my hopes go with you. Good luck.
Operations does good work.
Wherever the Crimson Fleet go, we'll follow.
and tires old and dead and worn. But I trust my old engine to get back by morn. Way out in the blackness. Way out in the void. Way get me back to my true love. As quick as an old asteroid.
Thank you.
we be taking off immediately, or are there other matters that require your attention?
The damage done here certainly indicates we are not the first to find the ship.
Recording initiated.
Full house. Damn it, Mayfield. You must be cheating. There's no way anyone can be that lucky.
Oh, yeah. I'm so lucky. Tell you what, I'll trade all that luck for a sandwich. Deal?
Yeah, sure. It's been, what was it, 3? Oh, 2 weeks since the food supplies ran out. If we had sandwiches to trade, we'd be eating them ourselves.
Simmons, go get some rest. You sound awful.
Yeah, I'm just gonna take a nap or something. I can't even read the card anyway. Sorry, everyone. Can't keep my eyes open.
It's okay. Go on. I'll come check on you in a while.
So, another round? Aguilar? Kellner? Captain?
You three go ahead. I'm just going to lean on Kellner here and watch. Oh, and let's cut the captain nonsense. Call me Liang.
All right. Liang's out. I'm dealing the rest of you in.
Crew recording terminated.
Always worth checking. Never know what you... might find in their pockets.
Recording initiated.
It's day 20 since supplies dried up. And here I am, staring at an empty poker table. Our last game. After Simmons passed, we kept trying to get together at least once a day for a game to keep our minds off of things. Kellner and Leong were the next ones to, step away. They wanted to be together at the end. Then it was just Mayfield. We played for hours. Now I'm alone. I just wanted to, leave this recording for anyone that finds the legacy trapped above Bannock 4. That's all. For now. Going to deal myself a few hands and call it a day. I miss you, Trembly. And I'll be joining you soon. GB Legacy. Signing off.
Crew recording terminated. Crew recording initiated. All right, so how long has Bakara been locked in there?
I'm not sure. A week? Maybe more. All I know is that he took some food packs and his duffel into the head and locked himself inside. Everyone's been steering clear of him since he scared Simmons, so we didn't even realize he did this till today.
Bakara! Can you hear me? You need to open this door and let us in!
The hell with it. I'm going to use the override.
I've already tried that. He's rewired the door or something. Maybe change a code. Not sure what he's done.
Kellner, can we cut through the bulkhead or the door? I'm open to any suggestions.
To be honest, I wouldn't go cutting anything in this ship right now. The structure is extremely unstable.
Damn it. Well, we can't just leave him in there.
Begging your pardon, but we can. It's pretty clear that Bakar checked out after our initial assessment. And he's been killing morale across the ship. Let him soak in there for a while. When he gets hungry, he'll come out.
I suppose you're right. Crew recording terminated.
Is something amiss?
Need to see what I'm... Right. Did they have anything of value? Like this traded by smugglers, but never one that is functional. This must be decades old.
Thank you.
to something. dinner takes off. Yes?
take what... I would like a chance to talk to you, if you are able.
Crew recording initiated.
Well, now, let's see. Another day's gone by. What's it been now? 6 weeks? Who the hell knows? Food packs from my ship are gone, so it looks like the clock's running down for me, and Issa wins. What a clever woman. I never saw it coming. I mean, I can't blame her. I was stupid enough to hand her the opportunity. Now the fleet's resting on her shoulders. I only hope she doesn't run the whole operation right into the ground. Anyway, let me just sit down in this chair.
Terminated. Crew recording initiated.
Son of a bitch! Nothing. Complete waste of time. Tried everything I can possibly think of, and I end up right where I started. Oh, here, I thought I was so clever. Thought I had it all figured out. First, fix my ship and get the prototype shielding back online. Second, shunt the power from the cred tank array back to the system to drain the credits. And then third, haul ass back to my ship before the EM field rips apart the legacy. Three easy steps. Right? Only problem is, I'm stuck at step one. Every system on my ship is dead, and there's nothing aboard this ship to use for repairs. I can't believe I came all this way, just to end up stuck here like the poor bastards who ran this ship. Actually, wait a second. Issa. Issa will figure it out. I told her where I was going for a reason. She's smart. She'll know something's up when I miss the rendezvous. After all, we're supposed to split the loot. All I have to do is sit tight and wait until she figures out that something's gone wrong. Then she'll come here looking for me. In the meantime, I should start rationing my food. I could be waiting for a while.
Crew recording terminated.
Beginning Currency transfer complete.
Thank you. That's all fine, then. Do let me know if you get a response. That is highly unlikely, but if it happens, I will be sure and tell you.
If you're feeling generous, you could help us out. Or we could just dust your ship. If that's how you want to...
Start charging for my services. Maybe another time.
Nice to...
What is it?
particular love for the UC. If you have the time, I wish to speak to you. What is it?
I screwed up, sir. I had the bogey in my sights, and I just fumbled
it. This pipe, it's gone.
Don't beat yourself up, kid.
The fleet started this war. We're gonna finish. The fleet have done a lot of harm. Now we bring the heart.
Time to show these pirates how SysDev does things.
My God. Is that it? Is that Krix's legacy? Amazing. Ensign, take this and enter it into the data core analyzer.
I'm on it, sir.
You see, Lieutenant? I told you he wouldn't let us down.
I have to admit, I'm impressed. Encrypted or not, it's quite a lot of money to be carrying around. The temptation must have been excruciating. I totally understand.
I can assure you that we'll take full responsibility for Krix's legacy from here on out. Now, on to other more pressing matters.
We received confirmation that the fleet ships were scouts sent to probe our defenses. Unfortunately, one of them grav-jumped away before you arrived.
Which means that Delgado will have the Crimson Fleet prepping defenses of its own.
There is little time then. Decisive action must be taken.
That's the plan. Lieutenant, if you wouldn't mind explaining our strategy.
Yes, sir. The Vigilance is equipped with the latest in hyper-resistant shielding, making it the only ship that can safely approach the Key. The catch is that the Key has access to three orbital defensive batteries that can fire electromagnetic energy. One hit, and we lose those fancy shields. Our mission is to take out those batteries. In fact, I'll be personally leading the assault on Battery Alpha. I need you to be my support.
Sadly, we didn't get as much support for this mission as I would have liked. There just wasn't enough evidence gathered.
We weren't able to convince MASS to lend us additional squadrons. They feel like they've committed too many resources already. That means we'll have to take out all three batteries ourselves.
It's unfortunate, yes. But we wouldn't be here if I didn't believe you could do it.
We've also given you a call sign, Renegade, to help coordinate our movements during the attack.
Once those batteries are destroyed, you board the Key and bring Delgado to justice. He won't come quietly. You do what you have to do. I knew we could count on your support. Well, this is it. After years of planning, it all comes down to this moment. All my hopes and my best wishes go with you. Good luck.
If you have the time, I wish to speak.
If you have any last-minute questions, now's the time. Good. The more you find, the stronger our case. Benjamin Bayou, pride of the Free Star Collective. The authorities there have been trying to nail him for a long time. Bringing us proof that he's been manipulating Jennerdyne from the shadows is pretty tasty stuff. The FC will pay dearly for this. Good job. That it? That's a hell of a story. Still can't believe Krix ended up being marooned on the Legacy. All that wealth, and the only thing he could do was stare at it. Can you imagine? I almost feel bad for him. It must have driven the guy crazy. Find anything else? Keep your nose up and your weapons charged.
Every soldier here is ready to bring the fight to the fleet.
damaged. Let's get out of here.
Thank you. Ready to on your mark.
Ready to on your mark.
shield system is damaged. Then it goes direct to the capability.
Okay, in sight. Let's do this.
Stay on your targets. Press the attack.
Thank you.
dealing with your flagship as we speak. I wouldn't expect backup anytime soon. Gives me plenty of time to blow your ships out of the void. All right, fleet! Triple share to whoever takes the traitor down!
All ships, defensive formations!
I'm taking you down. Grab jump down.
Cara's dealing with gives me plenty of... All right, freight!
Yeah.
Petty. All right, Freight!
that rate.
Tell us about Jasper Crix's version of the Crimson Scar.
All I can tell you is that under my guidance, the Crimson Scar became more influential than every other syndicate combined. Here I was, 22 years old, and I had power, people that followed my orders, and an endless stream of credits. Gale, I have to tell you, I was having the time of my life.
So you'd consider extortion, robbery, burglary, kidnapping, assault, and murder to be positive life influences?
No. I'd consider them as just means to an end. Those so-called crimes were merely stepping stones until I had enough wealth to buy the Crimson Scar a few spacecraft.
Yes, let's talk about that. It appears you weren't satisfied with terrorizing New Atlantis alone.
Oh, I've never stopped reaching, Gale. The amount of money we were making in New Atlantis was decent, but the really big scores were in space, on the cargo ships. We're talking millions of credits, maybe more. Who the hell could count it all?
Most people assume this is when the UC decided to actively set up a task force to pursue the Crimson Scar.
That's correct. Those idiots in charge of the United Colonies were clearly embarrassed that they had allowed the Crimson Scar to make the jump into space. They sent ships after us. Lots of ships. I almost think that they enjoy starting wars.
Perhaps this was the first time you had finally reached too far.
You could say that. I count my time running the Crimson Scar as a learning experience. I wouldn't say I reached too far. I'd say I reached too fast. Didn't cover all my bases. Made some
stupid mistakes. One thing's for certain, though. When I was finally arrested and thrown into the lock, I had plenty to think about.
Always with you, Freeze. Could we talk? What is it?
You did this to me. I can decrypt and re-encode thousands of credits in seconds, but something as simple as this, I didn't see it coming. Not in the slightest. And now because of you, my bomb's been activated. Which means I'm as good as dead. Forgive me if I don't take you at your word, since you've been lying to me from the very beginning. I've paid you well, treated you with respect, and kept trouble off your back more than a few times. Look me in the eye and tell me why you've allowed this to happen to me. You owe me that much. No. But had you given me warning, I could have started researching a way to escape this place. At least had a chance. Well, now that you're here, I don't expect that you'll stay and watch my rather spectacular ending. So why don't you just get out of my sight and let me die in peace? After everything I just said, you'd still be willing to help me. I must be a complete fool, because even though it makes no sense, I believe you. The only way to deactivate the bomb is through Delgado's computer and operations. You'll probably need his ID to get in. I don't know why you're helping me, but I sincerely hope this isn't another one of your tricks.
Best not to leave anything. Talking about this, remembering all those years, has brought back some unsettling memories. I suppose if we must.
the job personally? I don't know who the hell you are anymore. I thought I did, but clearly, I was wrong. What the hell happened to you? You had Krix's legacy in your hands, and you gave it away. For what? For honor? Justice? Looking out for number one, huh? So you did pick up some of my dirty habits. Maybe I taught you too well. You know, when we were on Suvorov, I saw the potential for you to become a badass pirate. One of the best. And now you suddenly expect me to believe I have been fooled the entire time? That this was some kind of elaborate game you have been playing? No. No way. For once in your life, be honest with me. Admit that you were tempted. Well, at least we know you are still human. It is obvious that no matter what I say, you have no intention of honoring our pact. You clearly never did. I have already locked down the key and set its reactors to overload. Soon, you, me, and everyone near this station are going to be vaporized. Let's see how far that loyalty to Systef takes you now. Ikande must be so proud that he has turned you into a proper little soldier. A noble death, is it? Suit yourself!
Thank you.
disarmed the bomb. Then, per our deal, you can tell your commander I will come peacefully. So you disarmed the bomb?
Yes.
Hey.
Pardon?
Yes?
What?
Okay,
wait.
Hello.
Can we speak for a moment? Clamps released.
Flying, kid. You earned your wings today.
Thank you, sir. I was just trying to do my part.
A lot of heroes on this day. Speaking of which, here comes one now.
You know, I had my doubts about you. Once a criminal, always a criminal. You know how it is. But then I asked myself, as spectacular as I am, can I do what you do? And the answer was an emphatic no. See, I'm a great shooter, but a straight shooter. And that wasn't going to win this war. What we needed was someone standing on their side with a boomerang gun. We needed someone whose bullets curved. No ride like a blindside. That's what I say. Anyway, you got a date with the commander. I figure he'll sprain something trying to pin the medals on your chest. But in all honesty, you deserve it.
Great job.
You have permission to speak freely. I believe congratulations are in order. With this decisive blow, the end of the Crimson Fleet is all but assured. But as much as I'd like to begin this celebration, technically we're still in the process of wrapping up the operation. On that note, Lieutenant, what do you have for me?
Reports are coming in right now, Commander. Delgado is confirmed dead, but Shinya Voss has been detained and taken into custody. Also, we've transferred personnel to the Key to secure the location until the United Colonies decides what they want to do with the station.
And what about Neva Mora?
According to our reports, Neva led the strike force that attacked the Vigilance. Unfortunately, that was the last we saw of her. It looks like she managed to escape. We don't know her current whereabouts, but I have our operations team looking into it.
That's fine. Overall, excellent news, Lieutenant. I have to admit, for the first time in 7 years, I don't know what to say. How about you? I know that was difficult. You hanging in there? I can understand that. The dual life you are leading must have been incredibly stressful.
Honestly, I have no idea how you kept it all together.
Well, let me let you in on a bit of a surprise. Something I've been working on for a while. I've twisted arms and cashed in some favors at Mast. I wanted to make sure you got a share of the money you recovered from the legacy. Call it a reward, a token of appreciation, whatever the hell you want. But you've absolutely earned every credit.
Eliminating the fleet is reward enough. But I will certainly not complain about the extra credits.
Don't thank me yet. If it had been completely up to me, you'd get a lot more than they're giving you.
Now that you're rich and famous, maybe you'll still remember us little people, huh?
Decorum, Lieutenant? Damn, I'm going to be really sorry to see you go. You've really become an important part of our team. It won't be the same around here without you.
Although, if you feel like staying aboard, I'm sure I could give you access to the SysDef mission board. That is, if you can stand spending another minute with us on Vigilance.
Excellent. I'm happy we haven't somehow frightened you away. Anyway, enough talk. You've earned a break, and I'm sure you wish to celebrate. Here's your promised reward. And wherever you might find yourself, my best wishes travel with you.
If you have the time, I wish to speak to you.